Hi everyone, today we are going to see about how to generate a code coverage for your Spring Boot application. In this demo, we are going to cover the code coverage for your application. So you are writing a test cases, right? For those test cases, how many cases you have covered? So we can see the report in this demo. So this is the builder gradle file, and then this is the test file. So in this API, in this project, I already have 5 APIs. So far the 5 APIs I have written the test cases: get list of greetings, and then create, update, delete, and get greeting by ID. So these are the test cases I have written. Okay, so look at here. Now this is the abstract test for the test files. So this is the method to convert the string into a JSON string into object, and then object into JSON string and everything. I just want to run this. I just want to take a build of this application. Okay, by using the command gradle clean build. This is a gradle project I am using in my machine. Okay, so look at here. The build is successful. The test task has run, but we didn't see any logs and then everything. Just first we can add the test to logs. Just want to make sure all the test cases are paused. Okay. Before that, I like to show you the test report. So if you add the test cases, you can see the test reports under the build reports directory. So look at here, all the test cases are paused. So the console log did not print any information about the test cases paused or not. So every time you have to come and see the build and reports directory to see the test cases report. Okay, the first step, I just want to add the test log to display the test cases result. Okay. In the console log, I added the test task, the test logging. I'm adding the events, paused, skipped, failed, and then standard error, everything. Just again, I'm taking the build by using the command gradle clean build. The test cases are running. So look at here, 0 tests are completed so far. Okay, now the build is successful. You can see the test cases result in the console log itself. We added the test logging for the test task. So it's written the console log. For this test, we need to finalize the code coverage by using the Jacoco plugin. I'm using the Jacoco plugin to generate the code coverage report. We need to add the Jacoco plugin. So I added the apply plugin Jacoco, and then the test should be finalized by Jacoco test report. For this Jacoco test report, I'm adding another one task. Okay, Jacoco test report, and then the report should be the HTML based. So far I'm disabling the XML and CSV because the first step I don't need any XML and CSV based. I just want to generate the test report, the code coverage report in the HTML. Okay. The HTML destination I have given under the build and reports directory. Okay. Now I am taking a build by using the command gradle clean build. So I think it's running the test cases. Okay. Test cases are paused successfully. Build also successful. So look at here, the Jacoco test report task has executed while you're taking the build. Now go to the build directory, build and reports directory. You can see the code coverage report. Okay, so look at here, build reports, the Jacoco, under the Jacoco folder, the HTML file. Open that index.html file. You can see the code coverage of your Spring Boot application. So look at here, so far I added the test cases only for the controllers. So I am just clicking the greeting controller. So look at here, the coverage, the initialize object, update greeting, create greeting, create creating controller, delete creating, get creating. So coverage is 100%. The get creatings cover 32%. So the total coverage is 76% for the creating controller API. So the code coverage we added for your Spring Boot application. Again, I just want to show you, this is the test report. Under the build and libs directory, all the test cases are paused. So I have written the test cases for the web controllers. So look at here, we disable the XML test report and CSV test report, right? I just want to enable that. XML.enabled as true and CSV.enabled as true. So you can see the code coverage report in XML and also as a CSV and in HTML. Now, so that XML file and then CSV file, both files, and then HTML files, both files will be, all the files will be create under the repos directory after the build is successful. Okay. So now again, I'm going to the same directory, go to the build directory and then the reports. This is the Jacoco plugin. Okay. Reports under the Jacoco. This is the test. Go to the Jacoco report. Okay. Look at here. This is the index file, the HTML based report. And then this is the XML report and then CSV report. And then this is the XML report. You can see the reports in the XML. And then this is the Jacoco test report in the CSV based. So here you can see the details. Group, package, class, and then instruction missed, instruction covered, branch missed, branch covered, line missed, line covered, complexity missed, complexity covered, method missed, method covered. So all the code coverage details you can generate as a CSV file also as well as the HTML file. Okay, I just want to increase the font size so that you can see clearly everything in the video. So I just increase the font size. So these are the details we can generate for the code coverage of for your Spring Boot application as a CSV file, HTML file, and then the XML based file. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel to get more video alerts. Thank you.